Pero ang malungkot kasi, tama na ba na masuspinde, tama na ma-dismiss. But the damage is repetitive, right?
It's a,
at the end, you were right. No, you're right. It affects the environment. It affects our water resources. It affects the livelihood of our fishermen. You said that. So what is wrong with our overall system? Why does this keep happening?
Partially, you can attribute this to short-circuiting the system because of greed. You evade if the reports are true, you evade paying the appropriate taxes due to the government. And then at the end of all of this, if a mishap would happen, you're looking at the big picture of an insurance coverage, which would probably benefit not just the owners of the vessels, but even the secondary. There will be secondary beneficiaries. This is a long chain of insurance coverage that perhaps beyond the naked eye would seem profitable for some.
But which agency should be going around checking boats, for example? Sino
Marina.
Ang iikot? Ginagawa ba yon?
Like yung Coast Guard. Lahat ito magkakasama. You look at Marina, you look at Philippine Coast Guard, Ports Authority.
I'm just curious. So Terra Nova, being a big ship, has to be parked somewhere. It has to be docked, right? So for example, where was that docked, Terra Nova? How could that be docked if it's unregistered? So who should be checking all the boats when they are docked?
You know, the system elsewhere likewise is that they are checked either annually or after several years.
Yeah,
for
but which agency should be checking boats that are
Marina
docked?
Marina.
So, are they doing that, sir?
I that's what we're
because
investigating.
It's such a big boat to be parked. I mean,
yes.
Right, you're a big vessel, right? So I'm imagining it. Here's Terra Nova, it's docked. That has to be cleaned. There are people coming in, they're cleaning the vessel. Before
yes.
The vessel goes out to sea, you have oil that's being delivered to the vessel, right? So ang tanong is, which agency is watching over that area? Because like, for example, if it's a yacht, you have to park your yacht somewhere. So there is a part of a club or the Manila Yacht Club that's looking after the yachts that are parked. They're asking for fees, right? They're looking at the conditions of the yacht. Pero sino yon? How could oil be brought into the vessel? How could they clean the vessel if that's unregistered? Sinong dapat tumitingin sa lahat ng vessels? Akin na papeles nyo, patingin ito.
In terms of law enforcement, it's the Coast Guard.
The Coast Guard.
Yes, and then the papers are supposedly issued by Marina. Then when you dock in a port, it's the Philippine Ports Authority. So this
so
is
everybody
a,
is a doing their job?
They're doing their job, but some might have been remiss. Because
a very
of
big
the,
vessel. I mean,
yes,
it delivers oil.
Yes. Yes, so I guess clearances before being issued should have been checked, double check, and triple check. So that's why I mentioned yesterday that this is not just negligence, but perhaps induced. So you're looking now at a system because this is part of your daily commerce. That's how busy it is. Our sea lanes are.
Yeah. Okay, another question on this. I'm not familiar. Were Terra Nova and the Jason Bradley and Mirova, were they all docked in the same port?
No.
So the negligence comes from several ports.
Yes.
I see.
So let's wait for the outcome of the the investigation. I'm very interested in a vessel having two names. As if you have an alias.
Yeah. No, but I agree with you on on these things, right? But at the end of the day, Okay, these owners are insured and they could be sued individually, right? You have a class suit, you sue the owners. But the bigger question, I think, for a taxpayer is how do we make our agencies work? I think that's for me,
Correct.
that's my bigger issue. Because you know, you go
Correct.
after one owner today, it doesn't change anything, right?
Yes.
And I've been a journalist for 30 years, and this is so repetitive. So it's like eggs on the oil spill. Ideally, you don't want that to happen again. So you have to secure the process, you have to tighten it so it won't happen again. It's the same with us. You sue the owner, it's one owner. You take out one boat from the sea, it's just one boat. But it doesn't change the system. How? Why? You can't even drive without a driver's license, right?
Correct.
I don't
Correct.
understand. That is such a big vessel.
I
People are
commiserate
scared to
with your
drive.
feelings right now. That's
No, right? I
what
mean,
we're
people
trying
are
to find
scared to
out.
drive
So,
without a license, and the MMDA would stop them. Why aren't these vessels afraid to go out to sea? Why do you hate Senator? Where
yes.
is GAP? You named three agencies: Marina, Coast Guard, Philippine Ports Authority, clearly all ineffective, that they were all out to sea with bad weather, no papers.
Coast Guard was claiming yesterday that the weather bulletin was not that bad.
Oh, okay.
That was the claim. So it now boils down to a factual determination as to whether really the PAGASA issued a weather bulletin, no sail bulletin, likewise. So you're correct. It's not just pinpointing the blame, but how to tighten and give more teeth to the law enforcement functions and the wherewithal, perhaps. That's what Marina is claiming. Ngayon lang kami nakapag-computerize. Libo-libo itong mga barko. Hindi naman nakulang din kami ng tao. Yun yung mga the usual bureaucratic reasons for failure to really impose regulations. So let's see how Congress can step in.
Okay, you're an expert when it comes to maritime
I am
issues.
not. I am
I
not.
know, but I
I
wanted
am
to
not.
ask you, so any Senate hearing is an aid of legislation, right?
Correct.
So what do you believe, what are you seeing in terms of legislation that can improve the system?
I am looking at amending some finer points of our legal system that would allow not just the compensation of farmers, of fisher folks, when accidents like this would happen, but even the secondary tier of the logistic chain of the fishing industry. Hindi lang po mangingisda ang nawalan ng trabaho dito, pati po yung mga tindera sa palengke. Marami pong mga fish vendors sa Cavite, sa ibang lugar na walang paninda, nagsara. Hanggang ngayon sarado pa. So they should likewise benefit, derive compensation from whatever insurance coverage that would benefit not just the shipping industry, the fisher folk, but pati yung mga nagtitinda kasi nawalan din sila ng hanap buhay. So, an expansion of this would probably be part of whatever remedial legislation I intend to pursue. And then the aspect of the longevity of vessels. Hindi naman only po yung ano, if you're this one vessel was manufactured circa early 2000, so ganun katagal ba yung lifespan niyan? With wear and tear in, involved. So siguro yung ganun, the bigger vessel, ano yung dapat na parehong kotse, di ba? Pag sa LTO tayo, pag vintage, I have a vintage car, pero hindi mo naman pwedeng gamitin lagi, baka tumirik. So ganun din siguro sa
Tama.
vessels natin.
Oo, pero sino dapat magbantay nun, sir?
Marina,
Oh.
bago ka mag-register, pero pag nasa dagat na, Coast Guard.
Eh yung Philippine Ports Authority, anong papel
Pag
po siya?
dumadaong naman yon at umaalis sa mga pier.
Oo. So,
bakit ka
paalis pier,
dito?
ano pong trabaho ng Philippine Ports Authority? Dapat po ba hingin nila ang papeles? Tanong
Yes.
lang dito ha.
Yes.
Dapat hingin
Yes.
nga po. So
Correct.
technically, isn't the Philippine Ports Authority to
Correct.
blame also?
Correct.
Even
Correct.
under
It's like your airport. It's like your airport.
Yes.
Bakit ka lumanding dito?
Oo. Oh.
You have a permit. Were you authorized to sail? So, and then siguro there should be another a separate weather bulletin notice channel to not just the shipping industry but even the airline industry. Separate sila.
Yeah.
Hindi yung sa atin na signal number one, walang pasok kayo. Signal number two, ganito, ganito.
But
so,
clearly,
separate yung sana.
I'm just curious. Clearly, that day, those three vessels weren't the only vessels that were able to go out to sea. That's correct, Senator?
Correct.
Okay, so the weather is not the reason alone. Because may ibang lumabas, hindi lumubog. Tama?
Yeah, correct.
So the problem nung tatlong to is the condition, other than the weather, it's the condition also of the boat?
You're probably correct. And you must remember, even out there in an area which is disputed right now, reports came in that in some areas they were cleared of vessels that used to loiter in those areas, and referring to the West Philippine Sea.
Yes.
Nabawasan yung mga barko doon. I'm referring to the other side.
Yes. Uh-oh. So, Senator Tolentino, congratulations to you on this. You are the principal sponsor of the proposed archipelagic sea lanes law. It went on third and final reading with a vote of 22-0. Explain to the public, what difference will this make if it becomes law for the Filipino people? Anong magbabago sa West Philippine Sea kapag batas na po ito?
Sorry to simplify this. So for the first time, I think this is 18 years in the making. For the first time, you will have a law that will be designating three nautical highways within our archipelagic waters. And this will have to be submitted to the International Maritime Organization for their concurrence, because it has to be announced globally to all maritime countries, members of the IMO. That's pursuant likewise to the United Nations Law of the Sea Convention. And this is not just your normal sea routes. It will also include overflights, meaning to say aircrafts, foreign aircrafts, can now pass above that sea lanes. So this is likewise pursuant to another international convention, the Chicago Convention. It is now dual in application, a sea route, a sea lane, as well as an aircraft lane. And it will now allow our law enforcement agencies, and this will now include the Philippine Navy, to monitor where these foreign vessels would pass. So we just designated three sea lanes to enable foreign commerce and even foreign warships to traverse. Because right now, kahit saan sila dumaan, hindi natin sila namumonitor. Kaya minsan, you'll notice...
Will they respect domestic law, Senator Tolentino? That's actually, it's surprising that considering we're an archipelago, that this law has not existed before.
Yes, they should. The under existing maritime conventions, specifically most of all the maritime countries are members of this convention, the IMO. They should respect, and the Philippines with the passage of this law can now prohibit certain vessels to ply the route when certain conditions apply. For instance, if it is determined that it would be prejudicial to national security, if it would endanger the environment, if it involves a non-approved war exercise, you cannot do that. So A lot of things can now be done, and we specified the three routes. This is the Philippine Sea Balintang Channel, sa taas po yon, before Batanes, east and west, and then we have the Celebes Sea, Cebuto Passage going to Mindoro, straight out to the West Philippine Sea. And the third one would be Celebes Sea, Basilan, straight to Lucy, and Balabac, straight to, out to the West Philippine Sea. This is crucial because if you will notice, during the height of during the height or before Typhoon Karina, reports came out that a Chinese vessel was seen near Manila Bay.
Yes.
Reports came out that a Chinese vessel was seen loitering near the Lubang Island in Mindoro. So the Archipelagic Sea Lanes Law would mandate that all vessels traversing these three sea lanes should do so in a continuous, expeditious, non-stop manner. You cannot stop. Dire-diretso ka lang. Dire-diretso ka lang. You're allowed to do that. That's part of the law of the sea. That's the Archipelagic Sea Lane Passage concept. Dire-diretso ka lang. So, and you do so if you're a warship in a normal mode. So what's a normal mode? If you're a submarine, nakasubmerge ka. So if you're outside the Archipelagic Sea Lane, kailangan mag-surface ka. Kailangan ipakita mo yung flag mo kung anong bansa ka, kung dumaan ka ang submarino. And you're not supposed to pass the, what you call this, internal waters, yung loob, yung mga base. Doon ka lang sa Archipelagic Sea Lane. So with this, we will be able to focus the limited resources of the government, especially the Philippine Coast Guard, to really put in place a system wherein we can monitor these vessels. At doon na rin yung ka-up. Nandun lang sa taas yung ruta ng mga eroplano. Airplanes, planes, foreign planes should not fly above the landmass of the Philippines. Hindi ka pwede maglilipad sa ibabaw ng Cebu, ng Bohol, etc., etc. Nandun ka lang sa Archipelagic Sea Lanes. That's how this law will be felt, and that's how the impact of this law would really produce more predictability insofar as our sea lanes and air routes are concerned.
Okay, now will this law prevent, for example, China building another massive infrastructure within our exclusive economic zone? For example, what we've seen through the years, Subi Reef, Mischief Reef.
Yes, yes.
This law protect the Philippines from China once again taking over one of our maritime features and making it into an island.
That's a different item, because from the title itself, you're referring just to the archipelagic waters. So archipelagic waters, Karen, would mean from the baselines of the Philippines.
Yeah.
I have a map here
from the
baselines. This is a small map.
Yeah.
It's going landward. Going landward.
Pero paano yun? Yung landward, are you counting 200 nautical miles going in?
Iba no, yung from the baselines. From the baselines of the Philippines.
From the shore.
From our territorial sea going out. Territorial sea is 12 nautical miles from the baseline. So it's going landward. Okay. So yung loob, doon dadaan yung mga barko. Because nagtataka sila, bakit meron pang ganyan? This is what one of the concessions that we got a concession during the UNCLOS conference. That's what 1, 2, and 3. Sabi ng mga ibang bansa, okay, we will now recognize your archipelagic theory. That was during the time Senator Arturo Tolentino. But one of the downside is that allow the international vessels to pass through your archipelagic waters. So ito yung napalaki natin yung karagatan natin, pero hahayaan padaanin sa loob. But it doesn't include the prevention of that's hypothetical question you had the prevention of the establishment of islands within our EEC. So archipelagic sea lanes is from one EEC to another EEC. Entry point to an exit point na lalabas lang sila, dataan sila. And this is really part of the accepted international customary norm of facilitating trade and commerce, etc., etc.
Okay. Now, just very quickly on a different issue, well, connected to a bit, the bilateral consultation mechanism, right, between the Philippines and China. What do you hope to come out of it? The Philippine Navy says there are less Chinese vessels right now in our exclusive economic zone. And the DFA has said that there is a bilateral consultation mechanism ongoing with China. What do you want to come off this?
You know, this BCM has been going on for 9 years. I think this is the 9th year. If it produces a good result, so be it. Resupply missions are facilitated, so be it. But again, my tenet here is that the law of the sea convention is not just between the Philippines and China. The Law of the Sea Convention involves all countries. And how many countries signed the Law of the Sea Initiative? 159 or what? So it's not just between two countries. So there's got to be transparency here. Although I was briefed by the Department of Foreign Affairs, there's got to be transparency insofar as other countries are concerned. Yeah. They have to be informed what happened, what will happen. How did it happen? How can we be of assistance? Because a lot of countries are also involved, not just in trade and commerce issues, but even in engaging us in defense and other exercises that would really shore up our again, defense posture, national security.
I like what you said, that there should be transparency with the results of the bilateral consultation mechanism, because we've seen it in the last few months wherein there were accusations, allegations that former President Duterte agreed to this, right? And then it turns out he didn't agree, did agree. There was a gentleman's agreement. And at the end of the day, when two countries are involved, and as you said, more countries, there should be transparency in what transpires.
Not just insofar as other countries are concerned, but transparency to inform the Filipino people. Yes. Ano ba yung pinag-usapan nyo dyan? Bakit kayo nakapag-deliver? Ano, okay na ba yung ganyan? Because it involves not just the present situation there in Ayungin Shoal or even, God forbid, sa Bajo de Masinloc, kung ano man mangyari. Pero ang sinasabi ko, dapat alam din ng taong bayan kung ano yung nangyayari kasi nakataya po lahat dyan.
Okay. All right. Now, there's been a new development and I want you to watch this. And it's tied to, in the way, the West Philippine Sea, your stand, and also, I think, your political future. I want you to watch. This is a soundbite from former President Duterte, which apparently is a development coming from your resignation. Can we play that?
It could be illegal in the sense that it would involve the security of the person.
Okay.
Yung kay Inday, what is deplorable there is that it was taken na hindi alam. And for security, you know, hindi naman si Inday, walang kalaban yan. Whenever she goes, she does not need 75.
All right. Okay, I apologize for that, Senator Tolentino. Actually, that's a very long interview of former President Duterte. And they actually cued a different soundbite, but I'm hoping that they'll find a soundbite, but it's this soundbite. This is what former President Duterte said. I'll read it verbatim. Senator Tolentino is, nag-usap kami, sabi niya, aalis kami, iiwan ko kayo, maglipat na ako. So kung tatanungin mo ako ngayon kung susuporta ako sa kanya o hindi, iniwan niya kami, di iiwan ko rin siya. If I go out to a full campaign slate, I don't think it will look nice to the PDP party na umalis siya sa amin. Ibig sabihin, hindi ako believe sa inyo eh. Tapos susuportahan kita. Wala na. Ako naman, sa laro na ito, iniwan mo ako, bakit kita susuportahan? So I'm reading it. It's the exact soundbite, but it's in the news. So I want to ask you first, Why did you, ba't ka nagpaalam kay former President Duterte? I think it's quite well known that he supported you during your Senate run and you're very good friends. What happened?
I think my letter was out there and it's self-explanatory. You've read the letter on the basis of some issues concerning foreign policy, especially multilateralism and the bilateral approach. So I think it's self-explanatory. We respect the views of former president, a good friend of mine. So I would not comment further on that, Karen.
All right. Okay, so I respect that. And moving forward, what party will you be running in?
Right now.
Are you even running? Aren't you till 2028, sir?
Yes, 2025. Right now, I have positioned myself as an independent.
Okay.
As an independent, I position myself to be on the side of the people. Mm-hmm. If there are things that that need exposure or that would need transparency, like what happened yesterday in terms of that marina incident involving that vessel, so I came out and declared that probably the government might be at fault, and if they do good, I praise them. So I'll side with the people.
Mm. All right. Well, on that note, is there anything you would like to add, Senator Tolentino?
I just probably would like to thank your program again for allowing me to guest. But the two vital pieces of legislation which the Senate, the Congress just passed are really historical. The Maritime Zones Law and the Archipelagic Sea Lanes Law. We hope that this would really fortify our sovereignty as a nation, as a people, and really rally support, not just from the members of the International Committee, but our own people. Ito po yung batas na kailangan natin para pagtibayin po yung ating kasarinlan.
On that note, Senate Majority Leader Francis Tolentino, thank you for joining me today, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.